Hey, I'm glad you're here. I'm excited to be here. And we moved the Friday show to Thursdays at 8 p.m. I don't know if you saw that yesterday, but I had promised to give away something today at 3:30, which was our normal time to do the live Q&A. So I'm going to give away. All you had to do is like and share or comment and share something over up here on the page at the top to win. And we're going to pick a winner here shortly. Heather's going to select a winner. She uses a randomizer to take anybody that did those things, put it in this thing, and it goes, bloop, 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 bloop. I don't know if it makes that noise, but it sounds good, right? So Troy's here. Ken Packer's here. We've got, let's see, Ken says, I'm going to plug this up real quick. I'm going to tell you real quick what we're doing today. Budget products or not. This is just some helpful information about getting deals on products that you sell and what not to buy and what to buy. There's a lot of it that's left to you in your region, but some of it's not left up to you. Or if it is, and you make the wrong decision, it could be disastrous for your business. So I do want to say hi to everybody that's joining in live. And I appreciate you being here. Eddie, Jose, Davis, Dean, thanks for being here. Ken says, let's see. Ken says, catering for you is fired up. We have always been a weekend and festival warrior, but this Saturday in East Tennessee, we will be setting up at our first food truck rally, selling our world famous Packers lemonade, Nathan hot dogs, and Johnsonville brats. Purchased your BYO course 2 years ago and have not looked back. Can't thank you enough, Ben. Ken, awesome. I believe Ken won something yesterday. He answered a question like that, that we did a contest. Big Mike is here. Thanks for being here. I appreciate y'all being here. But let's talk about this real quick, and I'm not going to keep you long, okay? This won't be a real long show unless you have lots of questions, then I'll stay longer and answer your questions. But I want to talk about budget stuff, budget products, especially when you're starting out. There's a tendency to try to find the best deals, the cheapest deals on stuff. Now, you can get, like in my area, people like the beaks and pecker dogs, I call it. It's the hodgepodge of different meats, hot dogs. They like the softer dogs, not the all beef. Now, I like the all beef, and I went with all beef because in my taste test, it was 6 of 1, half a dozen the other. So we went with all beef. That way I could market it as all beef. And most vendors do all beef. Some vendors don't. When I go to do a catering event or something, people sometimes have a suggestion, hey, I want ballpark or whatever. And they don't want the all beef franks. Okay. So, but there's a tendency sometimes to scrimp elsewhere, to buy no name brand ketchup, no name brand mustard, no name brand. Well, it doesn't matter. I don't care if something doesn't have a name brand associated with it, but you probably don't want to put that in front of the customer. So either use ketchup mustard bottles that you pour your condiments into, preferably the in-out bottles. If you'll look those up, they're on the resources page at learnhotdogs.com, but those allow you to fill from the bottom, squirt from the top kind of deal. That way you're always you're moving your product. You don't ever have to empty it out and then put the new in and the old back on top. So that's how that works. But what if you buy a cheap mustard from some discount grocery store, right? You never heard of it. Try it first. Please, please try it first. Maybe let some other people try it, because I've bought crappy mustard before when I started. I bought some. We have this discount place over in Newport, Tennessee, and you can get some really good deals. Problem is you don't want to eat it, but and you eat it once and then you never come back. And that's what I don't want to happen to you on your cart. I don't want them to never want to come back or start bad mouthing you. They need to want, oh my gosh, that's the best dog I ever tasted. Well, French's mustard is probably one of the most popular. Heinz is also another good one. Heinz has ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise packs. You can get them at Sam's and Costco and any of those places. And sometimes the grocery store has them in the 3-pack, just the smaller version of it. But either way, those are known brands. Are there some brands, though, that are no-name brands that are good? Yes, Cisco carries some no-name brands that are really good. Sam's carries some brands that are really good. Taste test them first, but don't go to this, back on the back alley of town discount grocery store and expect to get a really good quality product. And sometimes, and I made this mistake too, I've gone into these places these discount places and it be a name brand, but its shelf life expired. Not that it's going to hurt anybody, but everything decays. Everything decays. Rocks decay. Okay? Everything is made up of, you've heard of doing carbon dating and stuff? Well, it's because everything pretty much is made of carbon, right? Everything leaves a has a br atomic breakdown. Okay? So that's why some things say use by date. It doesn't mean typically that it's bad. It just means that it can lose its flavor, lose its potency. Like medicine, they tell you to use it by this date because it loses potency. The atomic atoms in it break down. Okay? So that's what I want to tell you is if you find a deal, do that. When you're just getting started out there, there's places like, and hopefully you have some of these, but there's places like we have Save a Lot. It's called Save a Lot. It's just like a grocery store. It's not as big as Food Lion or Harris Teeter or Publix or Winn-Dixie or Kroger. It but or Walmart shopping store. It but they have some good deals sometimes. Like right now, they've got a deal on hot dogs. Okay, they got a deal on Johnsonville brats. Okay, they've got a deal on I think their hot dogs right now. I think. Let me see if I can pull this up real quick. Sometimes I'm good at this. Sometimes I suck at this. Okay, they have Bar S Franks. Not the best. Those are the chicken pecker and big dogs. But I've got some vendors that are selling those with great success, especially in areas where that's what they grew up on. They grew up on this cheaper type hot dog, and that's what they expect when they get there. They want that cheaper type hot dog. That cheaper hot dog may work for you. They have them right now for basically $10, well, 9.91 or something for 10 pounds of it. So, and they're the jumbo. So you get for 99 cents, you get five jumbo or 4 quarter-pound dogs, 4 quarter-pound dogs. So for 99 cents, that's just dirt cheap. Well, if you're doing an event or you're doing something and you want to have a jumbo dog, that's a great place to do it. They also make these. Sometimes Save a Lot will have them. I was in, I want to say it was Food Lion yesterday, and they had these supersized Italian sausages or smoked sausages, supersized, half pound each. Well, imagine that having that at a fair or festival or event, and you've got this $10 Whopper dog, right? And they got and you serve it with a drink and chips for, let's say, $10. Well, a lot of people, husband and wife, pull up there. They want, we'll just cut it in half and we'll split it. And then they still buy another drink and chips. So now you're at another $2. So now you've sold it for 12. You just got 2 $6 meals. Well, that big thing was only like 65 cents a piece or 85 cents a piece. So check out those things, but always taste them. Okay, always taste them and maybe get some other people to taste them too, because we don't all have the same taste, but we all know what suck tastes like. You know, what something tastes like when it sucks, we all know that. So I wanted to share that with you. You can scrimp here and there. You can find a cheaper foil. Not gonna matter. Nobody's gonna go up, what brand foil are you using? But they will ask you what brand mustard you're using. They might ask you what brand ketchup, okay, if it's not displayed. Because there's some ketchups that suck to me. I don't know if y'all had fancy. It's called fancy ketchup. Hate it. I don't know who makes that, but I hate it. I can do a blind taste test and tell you which one's the fancy one. And use fancy nuck anyway. So just keep that in mind. That's my 2 cents on that. I'm gonna go back over here and let's see. Okay, let me go through the questions, then I'm gonna pick a winner real quick. Or I'm not gonna pick a winner, but Heather over there. Let's see. Taste is regional, absolutely. Troy's says, "Woo! Thanks for all these." Hello, Davis. Hey, Jose. Dean. Billy Blair. Let's see. Jason. Big Mike. Love it. Good afternoon, Ben. Looking forward to what you have for us today. Kevin, thank you very much. I appreciate it. What's up, Ben? Turned in my paperwork to the health department today for this cart. Super excited to get going soon. Congratulations, Kenny. That is fantastic news. Keep us updated. Bubba, Mason. Hey, Ben. What's up, Ben? What's up, Ben? Hello, fellow slingers. That was from Jim Hood, Jeff Davis, Ben Dean. Ben, it's Ben here. Hey, hey. Yep, the best name on the planet right there. Jeff Davis, just got my LLC form 2 days ago. Hitch installed this weekend. Financing joined up for our financing. Joined up for my cart. Should be good within a week. Freaking awesome, Jeff. That is, congratulations. I love to see people take action. When people take action, and that's what y'all are doing. How about shelf-stable products? Shelf-stable products, what do you mean by that, Jose? As far as, there's lots of products that are shelf-stable. I don't know what the question is around it. I'm starting to read Ben's book again. Has a lot of great information in it. I would agree. Of course, I'm a little biased, but yeah, it does have a lot of good information. And we add new information at the blog. We add new information, private information, and super secrety successful information over in the Vendors United group. If you're not a member of Street Food Pro and Vendors United, you should be there. Ron Pendleton, my wife is literally meeting right now with someone who agreed to be our commissary, can finally move on with the process. Congratulations, Ron. That's freaking awesome. Lisa Carp, hi everyone. Going Coastal Dogs and Catering is in the house. Love it, love it, love it. I hope y'all can see these. I'm putting them up, but for some reason, let's see if I can scroll this up. I'm going to hide that. I'm going to hide that, put that back up. Maybe it's showing. I can't tell. Okay. So good afternoon. Tony says, good afternoon. Howdy. Taste is so regional. Yes, it is. Taste is regional. You might be a transplant. You might've moved. And I've seen this mistake where a vendor moves from Chicago, New York, somewhere. And then they think, oh, they're going to love this. They're going to love a Chicago dog. I thought the Chicago dog is the brilliant hot dog. I love them, right? I put them on my cart and they failed miserably. I had people going, I don't want no salad on my dang hot dog. Just give me chili and cheese. I just want slaw. I want mustard, whatever. They ketchup. It just didn't work here. Did I sell a few? Poquito. Ketchup and hot dogs is illegal. Jose says ketchup and hot dogs is illegal. You know what? It's one of the most asked for condiments in the South. Go ahead. Don't ask me. I like ketchup too, though. I eat ketchup. I put ketchup, mayo, mustard. You go out West, they blend that together. They call it fry sauce. It's perfect for a hot dog. It's beautiful. Just getting started. Lynn is just getting started. Congratulations, Lynn. You're in the right place. Fancy made by Mickey D's. Is fancy made by Mickey D's? Well, it sucks. Hate it. To me, it's my personal opinion. And so always great advice. Thank you, Chris. Thank you for saying so. Troy, anyone use Mount Olive Sweet Relish? Yes. I like Mount Olive. That comes out of North Carolina. It's actually good. I like their pickles. If I have my preference, it's going to be a Vlasic. Okay. But Mount Olive is good. I like it. I like it, like it, like it. So I can't complain. Grew up on that stuff. So, let's see. The DIY cart is which one of your carts? And do you think you would do a DIY of your stand-in cart? You know what? Here's the cool thing, Alexis. This is cool. The DIY, the do-it-yourself, go to buildacart.com. That's what she's talking about. Buildacart.com. We have a DIY course there. Teach you how to build a cart. But it also teaches you how to build the sinks, how to build everything you need. And you can do it all. If you're gung-ho, you can do it in less than a week. If you're like me, it may take you 2 weeks, 2.5. So, but it's step by step. Shows every single thing you would need to know. But if you go do, let's say you want a trailer, you want an enclosed trailer, and you've got a good deal, like Matt just found over in Knoxville, Tennessee. He just found one for like $1,600. He's building it out himself. Well, you just take that information and build the stuff inside the trailer. So you could literally start a trailer. Let's say you found a good deal like Matt, $1,600 for a trailer. Okay. And he got a 24 footer, I believe. Huge dual axle trailer. Okay. For like $1,600 used. ready to go, except nothing inside. He just needed to add the stuff. We show you how to do that in the DIY course. The Build a Cart course has everything you need to know to build everything. So you could build it all in there. We've had vendors take that concept and create an amazing cart. There's a guy in California that built one to LA County standards, okay? Got approved, filmed his walk around with the health inspector after he got done, gave us over 400 photos and videos of his process, and it's all on the blog at learnhotdogs.com. Look at what he did. He's got solar powered radio speakers in it. He's got refrigerator. He's got all kinds of stuff, and he built it to California specs, and he did it all for less than he could have just gone and bought a brand new cart for. So yes, you can. I'm sorry I went on a rant there. Ketchup or mayo, some is, Jose, ketchup and mayo, both, you'll see on them. Most of them aren't in a refrigerator section. They're on a shelf. So they're shelf stable. Now, what they will tell you is that's room temperature. Okay. So if it's out in the hot sun all day, not going to be shelf stable because you ain't really got it on a shelf. So you will want to, like my ketchup, mayo, I keep a pan on top of the cart with ice in it or ice packs. I prefer the gel packs. They don't melt and they stay cold longer than ice does. And so I'll put those in there, keep them in there. But I use the smaller squirt bottles, you know, the like the 16 ounce in and out bottles. I've shown those on here before. I use those in and out bottles. And then when I get low, I just grab another pair out of my cooler. That way I've always got a good flow. And I never even pull them out till I'm ready to start. You know, like I'm all set up, got dogs boiling. I've got everything ready. And then I pull out my condiments that I'm going to need. Unless I'm going to be keeping everything on ice. And if it's a big event or something and I've got multiple tables, I'll have everything in beds of cold packs as well, you know, gel cold packs. That way I keep everything cold. Check out the mobile tiki hut. I'm building our big dog rolls onto it. Freaking awesome. Ron Pendleton just posted up a link to with photos so you can go check out his mobile tiki hut, and he's putting his big dog up on it on the trailer. That is cool as crap. Thanks for sharing that, Ron. Sun is shining and we are slinging. Nesbitt's curbside rocking it out. That is fantastic. Let's see. Troy Thomas says, thanks. Let's see. Jason, Street Dogs Jefferson City, Missouri will be opening its second cart within the next 2 months. Great advice, Ben and everyone else. Oh, yeah. I just bought a 16-foot dual axle trailer for $2,000 bone stock and will be opening shortly also. Congratulations, Jason. See, that's what we were just talking about. The Build-A-Cart course. Do the Build-A-Cart course and you'll be good to go. Let's see. Tony says, I'm using the DIY cart course to build a 30x8 cart island for my pontoon. Use the fundamentals and then customize. Exactly, Tony. It gives you all the fundamentals. So it gives you everything you need to know for all the crucial components and the building from scratch. And then you just do everything else the way you want it. Oh, I want a shelf here. Well, am I going to use, you know, 1x12 planks and polyurethane them? Well, guess what? That's approved in all states. As long as it's non-porous material, you can use it for food storage even. So that's what you do. Sloppy Dogs, 1.5 months from opening in Western Maryland. Can't wait. Thanks for everything, Ben. Josh Sloan, thank you. I'm going to go ahead and give you the winner. Heather just gave it to me. Harold Hollister. Let me see if I can get that in here real quick. Booyah, Harold Hollister. Thank you, Harold. For comment and liking, here's what you need to do. Email support@vendorsunited.com. support@vendorsunited.com. Say, hi, I'm Harold, and I won. How do I get my stuff? And all you need to do is just send us your address. That's it, your name and address, and we will get that out to you. You don't pay shipping. You don't pay tax. You don't pay nothing, and I'm going to send it out to you immediately. So congratulations on winning that. It's a cool toaster thing. It's cool. Anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed this. I hope this helped you. And if y'all have any questions, Ron said, that's why I bought a big dog. I can roll it into my rolling tiki hut or the pontoon boat I'm converting into the tiki hut. I think that's awesome. Getting laid off in July, thinking about buying a big dog with my severance package. Joshua, just go get your, that gives you plenty of time to do due diligence. You could already have locations. You could already have catering gigs. Had a guy call me. I think I talked about this on Monday or Tuesday. The guy that called me in the morning that had, he's over the mountain from us in somewhere like middle of North Carolina. He's already got jobs lined up and doesn't even have his cart yet. He's got events. So small ones, like small catering stuff. And I think that's awesome. Congratulations to all them. Happy Jack's in the house. Greg says hi to everybody. I thank y'all for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this. Much love to you. Have a happy weekend. I will be out through the weekend as far as I'll come on and do some, probably some tips or something maybe. But I hope y'all have a fantastic weekend. Thank you, John, for wishing me a happy weekend. I appreciate it a bunch. And we'll talk to everybody later.